When Netflix declare themselves to be a global TV company, Marco Polo is pretty much exactly what they mean. If you haven't seen it before, it's the complex political martial arts drama about the relationship between a young Italian merchant and a Mongolian leader, Kublai Khan, who's also a big fan of innovative haircuts. The show is written by an American. It's shot in Malaysia, Kazakhstan, and Italy. It stars Chinese, Canadian, British, and tons of Australian actors. It's being called the second most expensive show on TV behind Game of Thrones. And at the centre of all of that is this guy, the man who plays Marco himself, Lorenzo Richelmi. So the thing with Marco Polo is that it's huge. You've got so many people of so many different ethnicities working on the shoot. It's a little bit like, I imagine it to be a little bit like the United Nations of film sets.
And unfortunately I was the only Italian. So I was like the only black Italian sheep there in the middle of nowhere, understanding anything.
I conscript you into the Order of the Mongol Knights. You honored me. Great Khan.
So how has it changed your life, suddenly being on this kind of this huge show?
That's a good question. You know, learn English, that was the first problem because I couldn't speak English before.
Really?
At all. My English was like a middle of between Indian guy and Pakistani in the 70s. It really was something that you would never understand. And of course, I traveled a lot.
Did you learn English in India by any chance? Could that be how we got like this?
Actually, it was the first nation I ever traveled in. And I started to tick a bit like that, so.
Well, your English is fine. It's totally fine.
Mine is fine. Now it's fine.
You are not one of them.
It's amazing how I traveled so far for Marco Polo, how much things I've learned with this show, being on a horse with 100 guys. All costumed up, and the main thing that the director says, you know, just ride as fast as you can down the hill. And I'm on it.
I'm on it. I'm born to do it.
Because I was like learning English, learning kung fu, horse riding, sword fighting, archery, and whatever. Doing orgies in the show, and I'm being paid. What?
So, of all the things, I'm assuming the orgy was the most fun thing to learn?
Well, there is no lesson for orgy at all, but, it's like,
You just have to be gifted at orgies?
Exactly. I did this show movie back in Italy, and I had to play a gigolo, right? So, I had to be naked in this orgy, and I learned in that situation, that moment in the gigolo show movie, that you're not embarrassed because you're naked. Everybody else is because you're naked. So when I changed between, what do you want, a towel? A towel? No, I'm free. What about you? You feel awkward now? I guess, I bet you do. And that's the way you do orgies.
And that,
you just go there and you just feel free.
Is the key to
doing
an orgy.
It's just fine. I mean, you have to pay attention about certain things. But if you get fun, it can be a lot of fun.
The orgies or just generally the process of...
The orgies.
Okay, gotcha. It's been an absolute pleasure to meet you.
Mine.